Is our lab DNA, forensics,
fingerprints,
yes. NIBIN, which is the bullets. We have a state of ballistic. The art.
Dneska tady máme druhý díl o policejní stanici. Já jsem moc rád, že se mi tenhle díl podařilo dát dohromady už tak brzo, protože můj počítač je trošku kaput. Nicméně, jsme zase zpátky v plné kvalitě a videa zase budou vycházet dál. Moc děkuju vám všem, kdo jste viděli díl první, kdo jste ho kladně ohodnotili, kdo jste ho třeba poslali kámošům, kdo jste o mém kanálu řekli dalším lidem, protože tohle mě zase posune dál a můžu vám přivášet další a další videa. Takže si zapněte dole titulky a jdeme na to. Díl číslo 2.
It's just a whole, I mean, this is like a, when we first moved into here.
I hear a pimple.
This was like a maze in here. There's a office back here that is a, what they call a Eurasian task force. It's actually coded, it has a keypad coded. So nobody's allowed in there unless you're part of that. And they actually have to go through their regular background, then they have to go through FBI background. So they become dual agents. The whole windows, like all of these windows, they're all frosted.
Narcotics.
Yeah. So, and then their narcotics is back through here too. But yeah, again, a lot of these places are, if you're not part of that detail, you better not be found in there by yourself unless you have business.
Yeah.
So another new addition, and just the officers take a break.
Yeah, I can hear
so, ping pong table. And it's just a, you know, so you get tired of sitting at the desk working and everything, so they've allowed them to take a little break.
Yeah, that's very nice. So, I like all those old things.
History?
Yeah.
All history, some major cases. We had a guy that worked at one of the hospitals. He was the, I can't think of what it was, the guy who does the anesthesia.
Yeah.
And he was actually deciding older
six
people.
Counts for.
Yeah, he was deciding older people, oh, they're going to die anyway, so I'm going to put them out of their misery.
Really?
Yeah, so he was killing people. To him it was, but I'm putting them out of their misery. So they call him the angel of death.
Angel of death. That's crazy.
But a local.
What is the craziest thing you personally saw, like or case or like any like crazy shooting or something that sticks in your mind for
this was huge. This was like, are you kidding me? We have a guy that's a hospital employee
and killing people.
Deciding whether, and they even said that some of the people he decided they would have been fine. They just needed treatment. And that's how it came out, because the people were kind of like, wait a minute, no, they weren't that sick to die off.
That's crazy.
The other one is we had a huge Metrolink crash. It actually killed one of our previous employees, injured our employees that train in, so multiple of our employees were on the train and got injured and stuff. But
so this guy made it happen.
That guy, yeah, made it happen.
Like how?
I think he pulled his car onto the track and left it there.
Just on purpose.
Yeah, on purpose.
That's. And I don't understand why people are doing this kind of thing. Like,
and then you talk about shootings. This is an incident, the 400 Impala incident, where this guy was up in his apartment. It overlooked the freeway, the 5 freeway, and he was shooting outside.
On the cars?
Yeah, he was shooting just randomly. Sorry, guys. He was just shooting.
So those are the guns that he was using?
So yeah, he was just, and they ended up.
Those people are like.
But you can see all the rounds that went.
Yeah.
That
reminds me of the situation from yesterday.
Major incident. Yeah, it's pretty similar.
It's pretty
to
similar.
That. This guy
same
was
idiots.
Nuts.
Yeah.
They had to shut down the freeway. They had. I mean, it was just crazy.
Wow.
So we had negotiators there trying to.
Why need to have a gun of this caliber?
Yeah, this guy was just. I mean, he was. It was he had officers pinned down in the parking lot.
Oh, yeah. What you can do if somebody's shooting on you like that?
Yeah, they couldn't. I mean, they finally had to, you know, put tear gas in there.
There's a lab.
Yeah, okay. Is our lab DNA, forensics,
fingerprints. Yeah,
fingerprints.
Yes.
Niben, which is the bullets.
Oh.
We have a state
like
of
ballistic.
The art.
Yeah.
And that's where you see lab authorized personnel only. Is they don't let us
first
open before they do everything. They let us have a tour of it, but now it's basically
sterile
in there, and so you're not allowed to go in there.
This is very interesting. Like, I always wanted to.
So it's a regional, and agencies within the region can come through and ask for us to do work.
It was always amazing me how they can just, based on blood, can tell which gun shot it.
There was a guy. And it was a Hillside Strangler, I think it was. It was a Hillside Strangler or Domino's. There was something, one murder we had, was our DNA, our lab people managed, one of the detectives thought about the toilet paper roll, and they found a fingerprint on the inside of the toilet paper roll. And got the guy's fingerprint, and that's how they ID'd
him. I always thought that a fingerprint is only possible to take from something like a table or something like that, super shiny.
All kinds of things, but he got it. Yeah, he ended up getting it on the inside of the toilet roll. Because, I mean, who would you ever think?
That's a skill.
He was kind of, I think, like looking around and going, where are we going to find evidence?
That's
and
a skill.
Said, you know, people, they don't think about when they cook
a roll of
toilet paper. On the thing.
Wow.
This whole area back here, and we can't go in there because there's stuff on their desk.
I see that there's investigation.
So this is all our burglary division, our
I see burglary, auto theft.
You see robbery, homicide all the way over there.
Oh yeah, robbery, homicide.
So this is all the detectives.
All this crazy stuff I will never understand. When you deal with stuff like this on daily basis, like, do you think like that this is like just normal job, or it's like crazy every day you go to work and you're like, man, what I just witnessed, like
you never know. I for a while worked juvenile crimes and sex crimes, and you work sex crimes, and it's kind of like
for women, and like
it's
crazy.
We used to have to watch hours and hours of tapes, videotapes and everything, and after a while you're like
disgust.
You get burned out of doing, some of this stuff. And which is why they have said, here's a TV, here's a break room or refrigerator, eat healthy, take a break, play ping pong.
Yeah, so you don't get crazy.
Do something because
how
it gets...
How do you think you can work on this department and not get crazy? Like, can you serve that 30 years?
Oh, you could.
Yeah?
Yeah, you just... It depends on what you're working and what cases you're involved
and
in.
What personality
we've had some people that have been involved in some major, major cases, but they've just learned to adapt to it.
Yeah, you have to, otherwise you're out.
You do.
Otherwise.
And then some people say, you know what, I've had enough, I need to go.
That would be me after a month.
Else. Yeah.
Break room, yeah, I see.
Yeah, so just a more.
Yeah,
salt.
It's really big. Wow. Assaults, burglary, alcohol.
Yeah.
Wow.
And then this is so it's its own separate room that they have where we have other agencies that come in here to do certain things.
So you can test any kind of caliber?
Yeah, I believe so. Yeah, it's a state of the art.
Wow.
So you can't...
That's an art by itself.
Yeah, you can kind of see how far this area is all the lab.
Wow, okay.
So it just goes all the way back.
Interesting.
They've got... we had to do one time our thrill phone for a negotiation. Was inside the house, and they put tear gas in there. Well, the whole phone was contaminated. So there's a thing that's a hood. It's air, and it runs air through, so we put the throw phone in there and ran the air through, sucking out and trying to take all the tear gas out of it.
Damn.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy.
Have you ever felt like that you are in danger of your life?
You know, I don't think I've ever had anything really crazy during. I mean,
have you seen some
I've
officers?
Gotten into a fight, but oh, you know,
as normal here.
Yeah, but I mean, it's, so. Yeah, that's like one of those things. We've had officers running and being shot at, and we had an officer chasing someone, and the guy turned around and just started shooting, and the officer was like, ah! You know, we've had cars shot up before. I mean, we've had a lot.
Have you seen like a drive-by shooting? Or like, have you not seen, but investigate?
Yeah, I haven't done any investigation, but I've been out on patrol when it's happened.
So have you seen an officer being like shot or being dead, or like?
None of our one of our officers got killed since I've been on duty, but it happened. He was doing an investigation, went to a warehouse to get somebody. Went in the warehouse, the guy was hiding, laying in wait, and shot and killed the officer. We've had one of our officers. Shot, but had got shot in the vest.
Oh,
saved him, but he was bruised up pretty bad.
Well, better bruised than shoot through.
This is what we call executive role. Mm-hmm. This is the chief, the captains, all the administrative staff, our personnel department, everything. And again, after hours, once those doors are closed, unless you work in that area, you don't go in that area. They just figure you don't have any business.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
So, in fact, we can walk.
Yeah, yeah. We don't have to. It's okay.
No, it's okay. I don't even think it's Friday. So, this is the chief's conference room. He's got an outside balcony.
So, it's the main boss.
That actually has a barbecue, so he can host outside meetings if he wanted to. So, main boss's office. Let me just...
Oh, so this is the main one.
Sometimes he's
empty.
Here.
Is it because it's Friday?
Yeah, it's Friday. So nice. it's pretty quiet on Fridays. So yeah, there's probably two, three.
I like how you have the clocks in like the European way, 13, 14, 15.
Yeah,
you know, like,
we deal with time, everything we deal with time that way. Yeah. Military time is what we deal with.
Yeah, because for me it was like 1 p.m., 2 p.m. It was new because everybody's like 14, 13.
Yeah,
no, you know?
All and of our stuff is military.
That's the first clock I see here like
we
that.
We deal with military time.
Interesting.
With everything.
Little piece of home.
This is my... temporary office.
Oh, this one. That's very sad.
Pretty, it's just for the volunteers. So, our receptionist, our normal receptionist, is in Dublin right now. She's on vacation with her family.
So now, no receptionist.
So, no. We have to fill in as we go, and then our media relations person is in Australia. With your family. Yeah, everybody's gone right now. It's kind of crazy.
I like the TV that you have, also modern technology, right?
Yeah, well, and that's funny because all the offices still have these old TVs. It's the funniest thing.
It must be so heavy to hold on there.
It's probably the only thing that we don't have updated technology on is these old TVs.
It's pretty cute to see that here.
Yeah.
You guys can test like DNA and everything, but the TV is hanging on the top of this.
So this basically tells you who's who in the neighborhood.
Oh, okay.
It just lists all the lieutenants and above.
Okay. So lieutenant and above would be how many years of service?
It just depends.
It depends.
They have to test
school
to be able to promote. So you're looking at probably...
10 years?
15. Yeah. Yeah, you're probably...
Is it good pay if you're a lieutenant?
It'd be surprising if you make sergeant before 5 years. I mean, so you figure five, seven, you know, you just kind of keep going up and then you've got to have certain degrees to be able to get to that much.
So lieutenant is not on the street?
Lieutenant is very rarely on the street. There, if it's a patrol lieutenant, he might go out for
certain
stuff.
Or it's maybe sometimes I saw like a supervisor car, then there was something big. And the supervisor was going with them.
Yes, so it's a sergeant that will go out normally. He's on the streets. If you've got a lieutenant out there, it's usually a major incident. Or periodically what they like the lieutenants do is to get out in the field and just kind of... But rare,
to see the situation.
Yeah, you start getting into administrative areas with the lieutenant and above.
So far, I haven't seen any officers with donut and coffee. So is it really a thing that every officer is like eating a donut and coffee?
No, it's International Donut Day. So they did have donuts throughout the department today, I guess.
Today?
Today is International Donut Day. These are all of our past chiefs. Starting from this was our last, right here, and I've gone through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I started with this chief.
Wow, a piece of history on the wall.
Yeah.
You can even tell by this. This more looks to me like some like a guy like on like a mugshot, like some mafia don, you know, like the guy who's like having
yeah,
the
back in the
entire six, yeah entire family
back
behind
in the 40s,
him.
Yeah.
Yes, exactly.
Back in the 40s.
Exactly, not like a police officer.
Yeah, back in the 40s. But yeah, I've gone through six. I went through six chiefs, and now number 7.
Wow.
So and then when you came in, you saw a replica.
Yeah, I saw that.
And then this is. When they did this, they had this artist concept. They wanted not the typical thing. So basically with this, this is supposed to represent evil.
Mm-hmm.
He's holding back evil and then hand out
yeah.
the bed.
Uh-huh.
That's the whole representation of, I always say, the naked man with the blanket.
Also, you can demonstrate it that way.
Yeah. And that's
the phones
it.
Are, what are the phones about?
For dialing extensions, if somebody needs to dial an extension, they may say go up and dial this extension. But I don't think I've ever seen those used. But I think it's part of something that you have to have just in case.
So when you were working here, you had to retire, or you could be here even longer if you would want?
I could have stayed longer.
Yeah.
I had a back injury
from
getting hurt on duty. I got hit by a car.
Right. What? You got hit by the car?
Yeah.
Like some chase or?
No, it was that I was working the schools and the parent had been drinking and they put the car in reverse.
Oh.
I'd been fighting with them and they put the car in reverse and I was standing in the open
door. So it's like a...
To get hit me.
It's like an assault for the officer or something?
Yeah.
So...
Yeah.
Wow, so they get charged for that?
Yep.
Damn, so there was some...
But after a while, my back just started deteriorating more and I finally said 28. But normally, people stay 30.
Wow. Okay. Thank you very
much.
That was great.
So,
oh my God.
You can tell all of them and say, you know, I got the tour, you guys missed out.
Yeah.
Tak a tohle by bylo všechno pro dnešní video. Je mi jasné, že spousta z vás by určitě brutálně ocenila, kdybychom se zašli podívat na tu balistiku nebo do těch laboratoří a tak dále a tak dále. Nicméně v rámci téhle prohlídky to nebylo možné. Ale kdo ví, někdy v budoucnu možná. Rozumíte, nikdy nevíš prostě, kde tě vítr zavane, co uvidíš a když bude přitom kamera ještě navíc, tak to bude jenom dobře. Takže uvidíme, kam se to natáčení těch videí dostane. Já jsem strašně moc rád i za tuhle zkušenost. Díky moc Michalovi za to, že mi poskytl kontakt tady na paní policistku a ona taky byla skvělá, protože mi odpověděla na všechny otázky. Řekla mi, co si můžu natáčet, co si nemůžu natáčet a snažila se vždycky najít tu nejlepší odpověď, abych pochopil, a co se mi snaží říct a tak dále. Bylo to super. Nikdy bych nevěřil, že se dostanu takhle blízko na to policejní oddělení, že uvidím ty nápisy, že oddělení vražd, oddělení a prostě krádeže aut a tak dále. A bylo dost zajímavé vidět to, že ta práce asi tady je dost namáhavá, protože ten zločin tady je zase na trošku jináčím levelu. Jak třeba vám i taky říkala, že viděla některé případy drive-by shooting. Nedokážu si představit, že se auto naloží střelcama, kteří přijedou někomu před bar a každý tam vysype jeden zásobník a potom zrhnou. Jako tuhle mentalitu nikdy asi normálně smýšlející člověk nepochopí. Ale v rámci toho, když vidíte, jak ti policajti se tím zabývají, tak potom se musí nějakým způsobem odreagovat. Jo? To, že tam hráli ten ping-pong, to mi přijde jako celkem zajímavé v rámci prostě té jejich služby. A bylo dost zajímavé to vidět prostě jen tak z první ruky. Vidíte zase trošku v jináčím světle, než třeba vidíte ve zprávách, kdy vám prakticky ukazují nějaké jednotlivce nebo selhání a tak dále. Samozřejmě ne každý policajt je prostě úplně skvělý a bezchybný, ale bylo zajímavé to vidět i z té druhé strany. Takže tohle by bylo asi všechno na závěr a jako shrnutí myslím si dostačující. Díky moc vám všem, kdo jste to video zkoukli až do tohohle bodu, kdo tady zanecháte odběr, kdo řeknete o mém kanálu dalším kamarádům a já se budu snažit s počtem zrůstajících odběratelů zvyšovat i kvalitu těch témat, které tady budeme rozebírat. Jo? Takže mějte se, tohle by bylo úplně všechno, už to nebudu dál kecávat. Jeden člověk z komentářů dostane zase komiks a uvidíme se asi u dalšího videa. Čau.